Welcome back to Every Day in His Presence. Today we're going to be in the book of Proverbs, chapter 3, so go ahead and read the entire chapter. We're going to highlight verse 6. The devotional is titled Decisions, Decisions. Have you ever considered why you make decisions the way you do? Whether you go with your gut or engage in a rigorous analysis of your choices? What is the defining factor for how you determine the path to take? When you truly begin to examine your decision-making process, you may be surprised to find what really drives you. Perhaps you avoid negative consequences at any given cost, or maybe you are motivated by what others think. It could be that you live for the moment, seeking whatever makes you feel better. Or maybe you are simply interested in protecting yourself from pain. Whatever your determining factor, if God is not the compass of your choices, then your decision-making skills are faulty. Only He knows the paths you should take and can provide options you may not even know are available. So if you have a decision to make today, seek His direction. Lean on His wisdom because He will never, ever lead you astray. Isn't that the truth? Let's go ahead and review what Proverbs chapter 3, verse 6 says. The truth reminds us, in all your ways, submit to Him, and He will make your path straight. I underline that in blue because I want to obey His command. I want to acknowledge Him and submit to Him when planning ahead, because He is the one that will make our path straight. Yes, Lord. Went ahead and inscribed it in both Bible translations, one in Amplifying the Message. In the Message, which is pretty lengthy, but I love it, trust God from the bottom of your heart. Don't try to figure out everything on your own. Listen to God's voice in everything you do. Everywhere you go, He's the one who will keep you on track. Yes, Lord, thank you. Made a reflection and observation to acknowledge Him in all of my plans on a daily basis. Run to Him, not flee from Him. Run to Him and ask Him for guidance. Lord, help me step in obedience today. I want to acknowledge You when planning my days. I like to repent all the times that I usually plan all by myself, and I don't even bother to pray because either I'm in a rush or I'm too busy or I'm in control. And that's when trouble comes about. When I had counted my blessings, pray specifically, and I went, the additional scriptures that I cross-referenced to was 1 Chronicles 28, verse 9, Proverbs 16, verse 3, and Philippians 4, 6. In Proverbs 16, verse 3, I highlighted in blue as a command, and I plan in green as a prayer. Commit your activities to the Lord. And that's what He wants for us to do, for us to commit and submit all of our activities to Him. And then your plans will be established. And that is my prayer, for Him to guide me, counsel me, and then for my plans to be well established, well grounded in the Lord. So on Philippians 4, verse 6, reminds me not to worry about anything, but in everything through prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present all of my requests to Him, and He will grant the desires of my heart one day at a time. Well, you all have a blessed day, and we'll meet at a later time and a later date for another segment of Every Day in His Presence. God bless.